as always say, the politicians are to blame, the media. And then we have to realize that the police is also a human being. They aren't something different. So they are bound to read these articles. So it has an impact on them also. So many of the politicians are involved for the vote bank. What happened in Gujarat is nothing but a vote bank. If you see the riots that take place in the country, riots. Any riots, according to me, any riots in any part, in any city of India, especially Bombay, if the government wants to control, they can do it within minutes. Any riots. Whether it was in Gujarat, if they want. But then they take decisions. Like what happened just a few days back. They take decisions. Okay, we won't take any action. You be cool, you don't do this because for the vote bank. They are worried that if we book the culprit, we may lose our vote. They are not bothered about the truth. If they are really bothered about the truth, the culprit should be caught. The culprit can be caught. Very easily. But they take decision politically. If we catch the real culprit, will we get votes or no? We won't get votes, so don't catch the culprit. If we catch a wrong person and malign him, we'll get more votes, they'll do it. So number one to blame are the politicians. Politicians. So the politicians, they engineer everything. Otherwise, India is a country where our police is very well equipped, very well armed, but finally they're controlled by the politicians. So number one is the politicians. Number two is the media. The media influences these human beings, whatever articles you read. And in this past few days, I've been reading many newspapers and several, not all, but many newspapers. And we find in the headlines, Times of India, always read. Times of India, immediately next day, the next day article came about the blast on Wednesday. Tuesday blast took place, Wednesday article came. Thursday the article was in Times of India that this time the city did not come back in its position like the last blast in 1993. The trains were empty, the buses were empty, and they showed photographs. The offices, less attendance. The chief minister said, school should not close, but most of the schools gave unofficial holiday. And the full article headlines came that the city did not spring back to normalcy like the last serial blast. Another newspaper, 100% opposite. The city came back. The trains were nearly full. The offices were there. And they are showing photographs of absolutely opposite. In the inside news briefs, you may find, yes, some schools did not open. But the headline was, so when a person reads the second newspaper, DNA, if you read that newspaper, oh, the people are back to normal. Means whatever took place in Bombay did not cause a difference to the Mumbaiites. They are for work and they came back. If you Times of India only, absolutely different picture, two different pictures. 100% both headlines. Next day you read, it comes in one of the newspapers that LET and Simi are the prime suspect. The other newspapers are mentioned only of LET, Simi, nowhere in the newspaper. Here they blame one person. So when we analyze different newspapers, and everyone doesn't read 5-6 newspapers. Normal majority is only one newspaper. So I say it is the role of the media not to cause any rumor. And I'm told by people, news channels, you find that many things, when they get the news, without analyzing right or wrong, they blow it out of proportion. As though he's the male culprit. They catch a person in a burqa, a man in burqa, knowing very well he's not responsible, but yet they link it because they want yellow journalism. They want some news. So they link it that as though he was one of the prime suspects. Fine, he was doing something else. For his personal reason, if he had gone to meet his girlfriend and he wore the burqa. But initially the news is as though they've caught the real culprit without analyzing. So by the time the clarification comes, the news comes in headlines, clarification comes in news brief. So normal people, when they read, has to be this person in burqa is doing that. There are non-Muslims wearing burqa, that they don't tell. Non-Muslim actresses, they wear burqa for their own reason, not to be identified. That doesn't come. So what we have to realize, it is the media which creates an awareness. So therefore, unless we don't have a media of our own. So the point is that I do agree, most of the people throughout the world, at least in the past few years, and especially in the past few days, the suspect, if you analyze, goes because of the media and where the politicians behave. And many a time, even if they know that the culprit is a Muslim, but if they feel if we catch the Muslim, we'll lose our votes, they will not catch the Muslim. So the Hindu politician will not catch the Muslim, even knowing he's a culprit, because he knows that if I catch, I will lose my vote, so we let the Muslim go. On the other hand, the Muslim is not a culprit. If we frame a Muslim and catch him, we'll get votes, he does that. So most of the time, if we analyze the scenario, see, this is a different situation now. Blast is a very big thing. But when it comes to normal thing, the lower level riots and all, surely 99.9%, according to me, the police knows who the culprit is. The decision is taken by the higher up authorities. They can easily, there are photographs shown by the person who has done, launched the bus, yet he's not caught. A photograph, what witness do you require now? So it is the decision taken at a higher level that should we let this political party go or not. So if everyone is truthful that the culprit is whether Muslim or Hindu or non-Muslim, he's caught. Let my seat go. If few politicians down the generation do this, our country will improve. So mainly to the politician, they are more bothered about their seat rather than the betterment of the country. If they really think about the betterment of the country, sometimes if they take a decision, like a police take a decision, though they know the culprit, if we catch him, there will be riots and all for the betterment of the masses, this decision I don't mind. A small mistake someone has done. If we catch him, it will go into snowball. But not bother about the votes, bother about the betterment of the citizens of India or of Bombay. Then they take the decision, now we should not take action, it's fine. But later on when it subsides, they should take action. So such decisions taken for the betterment of the citizens of India, I'm for it. But most of the decisions are for the political vote bank. Now, should they catch the culprit or not? So as far as the bomb blast is concerned, we find several news coming up, as you said, that not yet proven. What happened? 93 blast. Yet the judge hasn't given his verdict. Many people are yet in jail. So imagine a person is more than 10 years in jail, not yet proved. Imagine if a person is proved that is involved in a certain case, how much punishment he gets? 5 years, 10 years, 15 years? Now already, more than 10 years has passed. So what we have to realize that I feel most of these things are politically motivated. According to me, that's my opinion. And the media. The media to let their paper be number one newspapers. Some media are biased that we are for this political party, so they support that. Some media, they are more interested that they want something sensational. So here I would say that, if I, that's what I mean, I'm a pre Times of India. The Times of India didn't give. I mean, I'm not the Hindi Times of India. Fine, afterwards then they may give that, okay, the prime suspects maybe, but not as headline like the other newspapers. But they clarify that, and here, as though it is in some papers, mastermind name so-and-so and so-and-so person X, Y, Z. So what we have to realize that we should tell the media to have restraint. So what happened? A layman, when he reads these newspapers, he starts making up an image. And imagine, same thing in America. Oklahoma bombing, what happened? Middle East conspiracy. The person was caught. He was a soldier in the American army. That comes just one day finish. So weeks it's coming, Middle East conspiracy. When they catch the real culprit, 1 or 2 days, they're out of the news. If you haven't read that day, you will think yet the Middle East conspiracy is there. So what happened? The mind is built up. So they cause the damage of 100 points to Islam. The news comes, they are not responsible. Negative 10 points. 10 points gets condoned. 90% net. So what happened? Even 11 September today, there's no proof. Prime suspect, Osama bin Laden, Al-Qaeda. I'm not in favor of Osama bin Laden. I don't know him also. I don't know if this is good or bad. But the thing is that when Yohan Redley, when she went to Afghanistan, she was asked this question. She's a British reporter. What are you with Al-Qaeda? She said, I doubt whether Al-Qaeda exists. That's her view. I'm not saying whether it's there or not. She said, I doubt whether Al-Qaeda exists. So what we realize that prime suspect, prime suspect, prime suspect, but 90%, more than 90% of the human beings, including many Muslims, yet think Muslims have done it. There's no proof. So what we realize that it is the media to be blamed, unless we have our own media, and we have to clarify. But one thing is to be noted, that killing innocent people is haram. In all the religions, including Islam, Islam goes a step further. Islam says in Surah Maidah, chapter number 5, verse number 32, if anyone kills any other human being, whether Muslim or non-Muslim, unless it be for murder or for creating corruption in the land, it is as though he has killed the whole of humanity. And if anyone saves an human being, it is as though he has saved the whole of humanity, the whole nation. And now when we find, when we see that where the CL blast took place in Bombay, fortunately, unfortunately, I don't know, most of the places are close to Muslim areas. And many of the Muslims help the non-Muslims. So you may find some reports, but not a lot of reports. But if we see that majority of the Muslims, they didn't think whether the people who were victims were Muslim or non-Muslim. They helped them. So hardly they showed such things. Hardly showed this. One or twice they showed. And in the people that died, on the news channel, people tell me they didn't see a single Muslim name. I don't know. I saw in Times of India, I don't know the number of names they gave, about 60, 70, 70, 80 names were given, out of which six were Muslims. So Times of India released one list which I read. In KM Hospital, three Muslims died. Another hospital, one, and one hospital, two. Two were doubtful, half Muslim, half Hindu names. I gave them half-half. So it's either five, six, or seven. I give six on average. So what we realize that here, fine, again. So now if you see the percentage of Muslims in Bombay, whatever it is, suppose 10% names are given, or maybe 8% names are given, and Muslim travel less in first class, so it was normal. So what we have realized that how do they portray their importance? We see in the newspaper that a Muslim family came to see one of the persons who was killed in the bomb blast. The moment he landed on the airport, he was caught and arrested. He was taken 15 hours in the jail, not given water. He came for the funeral of his brother, who was killed in the bomb blast. He is caught as a suspect of bomb blast. They ask him, why do you keep a beard? What are your hobbies? 15 hours they grilled him. And his family was outside on the airport, no water. So all these things aren't highlighted. It may come in news brief somewhere. So imagine a person who died in the bomb blast, and then he proved his origin. He asked a foreign company to send facts, even after they received that he's working there. Yet they didn't release him. Only after 15 hours they released him. So what we have to realize that even the people in authority, they are to blame. I know their intention. They're also working hard to find who the real culprit is. But even they get, finally, by seeing the media, even they become biased. So it's our role, we as Muslims, that we should have our own media and clarify. I don't know of any Muslim media in India which is really clarifying these issues on a very intellectual level. We should have our own Muslim newspaper like Times of India, like Good Newspaper, like Time Magazine, like Newsweek, and giving unbiased view, speaking about the truth, analyzing the fact. That will help convey the true picture of Islam to the world. Hope that answers the question. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين
يا رب إنك أنت السلام منك السلام إليك السلام فيا رب إنك أنت السلام منك السلام إليك السلام لأمرك يرجع أمر الأنام بين يديك قلوب الأنام